Hi everyone, welcome back to BOGObiology. This tutorial is going to cover proteins and nucleic acids. We'll discuss their structure, their function, and where they can be found. Different groups of atoms combine to form biomolecules. When we talked about carbohydrates and lipids, we used carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and sometimes nitrogen. Now that we're discussing proteins and nucleic acids, we're going to add phosphorus and sulfur to the mix. For every kind of biomolecule, it's important to understand its purpose, its location, and its structure. Using this information, try to figure out what the relationship is between the structure of the molecule and its function. Nucleic acids transfer the genetic code between generations and also provide a blueprint that cells use to make proteins. Usually, nucleic acids are found in the nucleus of the cell, although RNA will move out into the cytoplasm to take part in protein synthesis. Usually nucleic acids are helix-shaped, with a double helix for DNA and a single helix for RNA. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and phosphorus atoms are arranged strategically into the building blocks of nucleic acids. These building blocks are ribose sugar and then four other components called adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine. We also sometimes call these last four components nitrogen bases. In RNA, there is an additional nitrogen base called uracil, which takes the place of thymine. In the DNA molecule, all of these components are arranged in a shape that resembles a twisted ladder. Notice how the sides of the ladder alternate between ribose sugar groups and phosphate groups. Also notice how adenine always pairs with thymine and guanine always pairs with cytosine. The nitrogen bases are connected across the molecule using hydrogen bonds. Adenine and thymine are connected using two hydrogen bonds, and guanine and cytosine using three bonds. We call these sets of nitrogen bases complementary pairs. The order and combination of the base pairs in the DNA molecule determines an organism's genetic code. Cells follow this code in order to manufacture proteins. This is actually a great way to segue into talking about proteins. It's important to remember that there are many, many, many kinds of proteins, and we couldn't possibly talk about them all. A few examples are enzymes, structural proteins, receptor proteins, motility proteins, and contractile proteins. These are found in many different locations, including the digestive tract, the blood, neurons, cell membranes, and muscle tissue, but there are obviously a lot more examples than that. Proteins contain carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and sometimes sulfur as well. These atoms arrange themselves into something called an amino acid, which looks like this. Notice how one of the carbons has an attachment called an R group. There are actually 20 different R groups that could be attached to an amino acid, and they're what makes each amino acid unique. The R group is the portion of the amino acid that can sometimes contain an atom of sulfur. The 20 different varieties serve as the building blocks for proteins. A series of amino acids is strung together using connections called peptide bonds. Every time we attach a new amino acid to the end of the chain, we remove one molecule of water in a process called dehydration synthesis. When we've created a long string of amino acids, all connected in this way, we call it a polypeptide. When the appropriate number of amino acids have been added, we fold up the polypeptide into a structure known as a protein. The protein will have a specific shape that's based on the task it will perform. Remember that a molecule is not considered to be a protein until it's been folded. The way the protein is coiled up can also make a huge difference in terms of its function. Proteins may take on a primary, secondary, tertiary, or quaternary structure. When we have a number of protein subunits all working together, we call this a protein complex. Alright, that's pretty much it. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, I hope you'll consider subscribing to my channel and checking out some of my other videos. Thanks again for watching, and please remember to like, comment, and subscribe.